All right, you're done. Let's go look at the solution. Where we left off last time, as you can see, we have two empty queries for location ID and location. These two queries look a lot like the queries we have for weather. For location ID, this looks almost exactly like what we do for weather, except we use a hard-coded query rather than relying on the one passed into the function. Since we know that this is always going to be a long integer value, it is easy to just build the value into the query string. Location, on the other hand, looks almost exactly like the weather query. We just pass all the parameters into the database. You didn't think you were going to get away without testing, did you? Don't worry, it's really easy to add this test. It turns out that calling our function within the provider works almost exactly the same as the way we did the weather table. All we have to do is replace weatherEntry.ContentUri with locationEntry.ContentUri. And of course, we still have to delete the two columns that we can't support. Now that'll actually work, so let's test that to make sure that works. And our test passed, as expected. The interesting thing about this test is that it's actually only testing the first query, and it just happens to work because we deleted the database before the start. It'd be much more interesting to query for the row that we just inserted. And this will test the other query. Now let's run the test again. And those also passed. So, we have some of our queries in our content provider functioning. But unfortunately, we still have to do some of the more complicated things in the provider. Let's talk about joins.